And we had a ton of rain yesterday. In fact, Volusia County had about 4 inches of rain in some spots.
Wow.
And Mike Kirby was up in Chopper 2 HD, and he was able to grab some of this video here. What you're looking at is a bird's eye view of one of those heavy tropical downpours. And you get underneath one of those, and you are soaked in a hurry. And there's also those strong, gusty winds that are coming out of that rain there. That's a rain shaft. You see the dark color there. And it's just a neat way to look at things from up in Chopper 2. All right, let's go ahead and show you now live what's going on. That was from yesterday's rain. Now we're seeing similar downpours making their way in across I-75 here on Viper. Very little lightning. Temperatures up top are just warm enough to keep the air more stable, so we're not seeing this tremendous lightning punch today. Just some downpours rolling right through Citra on into Ocala right now, and they're traveling along I-75, just lined right up. So anywhere from Bellevue to Wildwood, get ready for the rain. It'll be passing through in about another 30 minutes. Bushnell, the rain is knocking on the door right now, and it's heading into Webster next. Claremont, South Claremont, Montverde, all these areas getting ready for some rain down the line. And as we go over to Brevard County, I'm looking at the radar here. There's just the very earliest indication of our sea breeze down here around MECO. So this is where you're going to have a southeast and east wind try to develop. So if there is going to be any threat for any rotation, any of those brief funnels, spin-ups, that kind of thing, looks like it'll be down here into the south and eastern portions of the viewing area late this afternoon as all this tries to come together. Let me show you the bigger picture on the Weather Plus computer. We have southwest winds today trying to limit that rotation in our atmosphere. But again, this is the area to watch, possibly around Cocoa Beach points inland from there later on. Temperatures right around 89 degrees, most spots, even a couple of 90s mixing in. You see the heat index readings, mid to upper 90s as of our lunch hour. High today, 94 in Orlando, Daytona Beach as well with those offshore winds. Melbourne at 92 with a little bit more of a southeast wind developing a little earlier in the day. And we'll watch out for those passing downpours right through the afternoon commute. 3, 4, 5, even 6 o'clock, I think by 7 or 8, well, we're starting to taper the rain down, but we'll carry that evening storm chance. As we head into Friday, a little bit drier, widely scattered storms, west-southwest winds will keep the beaches quite hot. Lots of mid-90s at the coast, even on in towards Saturday if these offshore winds continue. Now, yesterday, the models were really bringing this front down, really boosting our rain chances over the weekend. We're going to see if that does verify. We're getting some hints now that that may not pan out. But just know that as we're watching the tropics, things are nice and quiet. There's just one little caveat here with the remnants of Tropical Depression number 5. Some of the models are trying to bring it right back into the Gulf of Mexico sometime next week. So we may not be totally done talking about that circulation. There's your 7-day, though. Rain chances at 30% tomorrow, back up to 50% by Sunday.